Hi, my name is Shawn Michaels. I'm a writer here in Montreal. I've just published my first novel. It's called Us Conductors, and it's the story of the inventor of this real musical instrument called the theremin. The theremin was invented in the 1920s by a Russian inventor and scientist and spy named Lev Sergeyevich Termin. He did this work just after the Bolshevik Revolution, and my book traces the story of his celebrity in Russia, coming across Western Europe to New York, where he lived in the Plaza Hotel and, you know, partied with the Gershwins and the Rockefellers, and then follows him as he returns to Russia, where he gets banished to a Siberian gulag. And it's inspired by his true story, which is one of full of espionage and music and electricity, and also traces the love story between Lev and the greatest theremin player of all time, a woman named Clara Rockmore. So just a quick introduction to how this theremin works. This is such a space-age instrument, but it was actually invented before the electric guitar. You may have heard it in music by the Beach Boys, like songs like Good Vibrations, or Led Zeppelin, John Spencer Blues Explosion, Montreal's own late and lamented Wolf Parade. This is the only instrument in the world that's played by not touching it. It uses the central idea is these two antennas, both of which emit electrical fields, and the human player disrupts these electrical fields. This antenna, this one here, is used to control pitch. The closer you get to this antenna, the higher the pitch that's playing. Like that. And then this antenna, this curved antenna, controls volume. So once we have a pitch, this will make it quieter. So as you can imagine, the theremin is very tricky because you have to use both, guess at the notes in the air and where you want your hand to be, and also use both of your hands at once to stop the notes, to separate them. It can be lots of fun as a way of making noise. But the greatest players can really use it to play any kind of music, classical music, pop music, for a melody even. I'm not one of those players, but I'll give you a taste of what a terrible version of real theremin playing might look like. It's not for the faint of heart or the tin-eared, that's for sure. So this is the theremin. My name is Shawn Michaels, and my book is called Us Conductors. I hope you'll read it.